Welcome back to our studio. I'm working on our little barn today in this wildflower painting, this Texas spring painting. And this is the, I'm using mixtures of my mud, which is alizarin crimson plus ultramarine blue. And then I've added a little cadmium orange into that. And also then some white. And that just makes a nice, soft, gray brown that I'm using for that old weathered wood on that side of that barn. And this side is in shadow. Our light is coming in from the left, so this side's in shadow. And the part of the barn going back here I'll make a little bit cooler. I've added a little bit more ultramarine blue into that mixture, so that makes it a little bit bluer. In fact, this is even just some ultramarine blue plus white from my mountains in the background. Then I'm coming in with a little bit of my mud, just kind of give the board texture. And I'm using one of my bright brushes. That's a square brush. And that enables me to use the flat side to make these long strokes, or I can use the edge of it to make the upright details. I'm going to have barn doors here. I think I may have one of those open. I'll just kind of, this is again my mixture of mud and with plus a little alizarin crimson. That'll just give me that opening there. Now I'm going to have one door up there, and these barn doors have kind of a Z marking on them, or boards that hold the upright boards together. They have cross boards, and they usually have a Z marking. I'm not making this super detailed. I just want to give the indication of that. And then I'm going to have the open door on this side. So one door is open and one door is closed. And up at the top is the hayloft. Again, this is my mixture of mud plus a little bit of liquid. I don't want that real dark, but it just gives me a dark up there. Bring in a little, just a little hint of a dark in there. This door is coming out. And it also has the Z. And I can just brace against the unpainted part of the canvas to steady my hand. And the bottoms of the doors are really going to be behind flowers and stuff. Again, I don't want this, I'm just painting this impressionistically. So I don't want it super high detailed so that I want that barn to settle back into the distance. Then there's also going to be there's usually just a small door on these barns. It's just a people door. This is for like a big hay wagon or something to go in. And then there's a people-sized door over here. Now, underneath the canopy of this little shed roof coming out, it's going to be darker. But then on the back side, the light's going to be coming, since the light's coming from the left, the light comes in from under that roof and cuts across. I want this to be cool, so that goes back, but it's got to be a little bit lighter because the sun is hitting that part, back part of the building back there. I may have to come back and glaze that mountain behind there to show that light a little bit better. Right now, this is, you know, it's a matter of pushing and pulling. Just kind of get us blocked in here. That old weathered wood is just a gray-brown, and then we're darker. That back part of that shadow is going to be bluer to make it recede. Blues or cool colors go back, warm colors come forward. A little bit. There we go. So that roof goes, that part of the building goes back, and then up here is under shadow from the overhang of that upper roof. Now the roof itself is old tin, so it's rusty and red. I'm going to pull some blues into that and just different colors to kind of give it that old texture. I love these old tin roofs because they're just full of different colors, the fun paint, and just really cool. These old barns in Texas are just, when you discover them, it's just so fun to look at them. I wish they could talk. Love to hear the stories they tell. Just imagine the kids playing out there, the families they've grown up. Just add some oranges into that. This is a mix of cadmium orange plus white plus a little bit of alizarin crimson. I want a little bit lighter value of that. Again, this, I showed you a picture in the very beginning of the little barn that I'm using as reference. This was around the corner from where we used to live in Floresville. And that's southeast of San Antonio. This oak tree was actually right beside our house. It was, a tree expert told us that that tree was over 300 years old. I mean, Jack and I could not join hands around the trunk of it. It was so big. And I would, now talk about something you wish you could tell stories. I can just imagine there may have been Indians or Texas Rangers camping under that tree. Just would be so fun to, if they could talk. Okay, now I want the front edge of this to be a little bit lighter, so it comes forward. And then our roof down here is also tin. And it just comes right up under this one. I'm going to make it a little bit darker because it's, well, actually no, this one would be lighter. The more upright plane would be darker and the flatter plane catches more light above, from above, so it's actually lighter. So we need to make this upper roof a little bit darker. Just bring some darks into that. Come down with the edge here. And there's a little bit of a edge. Fascia board here on that tin, and then layers. I want a little blue along the back of this roof here. Now we're going to make, there's some openings in the side, some doorways to stalls inside the barn. So we want to add those in here. This edge is darker. Okay, now we're going to make our little openings or stalls and stuff. Again, these are not as tall as that great big barn door. I'm just using my mixture of mud plus liquid. Again, I don't want those to be just real dark. I want to give the impression of that there's openings there. Now we're going to bring some fence posts back here. Let's see, we're going to have there's a post here coming down from the holding up this little siding. And my background is still wet, so I can use it to clean up here, and I also have my background colors. I saved those, so I'm just going to paint that out and redo that little I'm going to make that a little bit bluer back there so that shows the light on the back of that building. Post exactly where I want them. So I can just paint those out with my background color. It's a nice thing about, it's really easy to erase in paintings. You can just come back and paint over and take that out. My posts. Still don't have those in the right places. I'm just having a tough time with this one. Let's just paint that out and start all over. Seems to be a little bit darker. And I've got a little bit of green in here. Bit of white or lighter. This is, I want just a little bit of light down in that valley. Soften that edge. Okay, now put my post back in. This one comes this. So we've got a post here. And then this one. There we go. And my roof comes out a little bit further. Fix this little dip up into the sky. Again, the sky is still wet, so I can just bring that color back over that. A little bit higher, too high up into the sky. lighten this surface just a little bit. A little more dark right in there. And there's our old barn. Thank you for watching my YouTube videos. Please subscribe to my channel. I also have a blog. The address is in the description, or the link to the blog is in the description below. I also have the address on the final frame of my video. You have a wonderful, wonderful day, and again, I really appreciate you watching.